Now to new developments in the story we brought you last night here at 6. A city councilman is closer to possible impeachment, while the mayor is now saying this, that taxpayers should consider themselves lucky to pay his girlfriend's health insurance. Investigative reporter Jeff Chirico live in Cumming tonight, where this political drama played out today. Jeff?
Yes, Scott, this afternoon council voted to launch an investigation into one of their own and whether that individual released this document. It lists the names of all the employees on the city's health insurance plan, and noticeably, the name of someone who is not an employee, the mayor's girlfriend.
What do you say to taxpayers who are concerned that your girlfriend is getting a free ride?
We'll have no more statements today.
Mayor Ford Gravitt was feeling the heat outside a meeting, but inside, Councilman Rupert Sexton.
We have a motion to proceed.
Came a bit closer to losing the position he's held since 1971. Council voted to appoint a panel to investigate whether he should be impeached. He's accused of making public a so-called confidential list of city employees on the city's health insurance plan. The city attorney explained the document appeared on social media last week, shortly after council shot down Sexton's proposal to add council members' spouses to the health plan. Sexton allegedly said
that he was now going to, quote, do what he had to do.
It's crazy.
Sexton denies he released the document and says the mayor is simply trying to hide the fact that his girlfriend, Angela Mullinex, has collected taxpayer-funded health insurance for the past 10 years. She's not an employee.
Ms. Mullinex, can you please explain to me why you believe you deserve those benefits, Ms. Mullinex?
Mullinex wouldn't talk, but the mayor tried to defend it.
She does a lot of work for the city of Cumming, and I put her on there. And I think the city pays $663 a month for her insurance. That's it, and I think we got a good bargain.
Are you worried that you may be impeached?
No, they don't have any evidence.
And there's some real debate about whether this document is even confidential. It contains names and hire dates, but no real health information of any of the employees. Now, the investigative panel will take about a few weeks to look into this matter and report their findings back to council early next year. We're live in Cumming. Jeff Chirico, CBS 46 News.